Hi lads and lasses, Modest Pelican here with GTA Online. If you enjoy this video, please become a pilot, but instead of flying passengers to their destination, keep flying as traumatizing as possible, while repeatedly playing my videos on the in-flight entertainment until every passenger is subscribed to me, as this really helps spread the good word of my channel. Meet Thick Man, a retired assassin who is on a mission to become the most powerful crime lord in Los Santos, whilst also ensuring he stays sufficiently hydrated at all times. These are the boys, and together they form a feared gang known as the Sons of Virgins. These are their stories. A new GTA Online update from our overlords Rockstar. It's actually a surprisingly good update, so pull out the baby lotion and pull down your pants because we're about to have a pretty swell time. I head over to pick up Stealtho Robbo, who's dressed like a salty adolescent whose parents just got divorced. Trust me, I would know, but this isn't my therapy session, it's a fun video, so glossing over my broken childhood, we make our way over to the underground LS car meet. Cue an uncomfortably long cutscene featuring low resolution dump trucks, drift kings, and Thick Man not understanding basic road safety. Look left, then right, then left again. This is a society. Honestly, I think Rockstar are trying to make their cutscenes so long that by the time you finish watching them, GTA 6 is released. The car mate is pretty cool. I get some Fast and the Furious vibes. Well, at least from the earlier movies before they literally sent cars to space. The moon landing might have been faked, but do you know what isn't fake? Family. Well, until your parents get divorced, I guess. I go and talk to Mimi and purchase myself a membership for $50,000. Robbo and I then head over to a pop-up tattoo parlor that probably doesn't value sanitation. I've already got the most alpha back piece available, but I get a few more so that other players know I have sex 6 times a day, or whatever the normal amount of sex per day is. Robbo also gets some fresh ink.
I've got a throat tat and a forehead tattoo that says sleepy.
Why would you want that? What if you're well rested? Shit.
You can borrow a car and drift it around on their test racetrack. It's pretty cool, but there are several large puddles of water and oil, which is an obvious safety hazard. I get they're trying to be a cool underground organization, but that doesn't mean they're above adequate drainage systems. Crosby arrives, which is nice, and then Robbo says he's got a special surprise for us.
Hey boys.
Hey, what's up, man?
Wait, you have to wait for the big back piece reveal.
Alright. Oh god, I want to kill it. Oh no, what is it? That's the same one that I've got!
Is it?
Yeah. Oh, that's wholesome.
Disgusting.
It's now time to do some actual racing. GTA racing is a lot of fun. It actually reminds me of Formula One, but every driver is Lewis Hamilton. I finished my first race in third place, earning a bronze medal, also known as irrelevant. If any Olympians are watching this, I advise that you don't bother returning to your home nations unless you've got a gold medal around your neck. Being the second or third best in the world at a sport is pretty cringe. I do get some wins too, but in the celebration screen, I'm reminded that my crew is called Thy Sons of Virgins. Still mad that someone stole the Sons of Virgins, but Thy does give us a Shakespearean vibe, and girls love poetry. I do sometimes research the pure shit I talk, and this would definitely be one of the stranger things I've googled. This isn't even the coolest part of the update. You can actually buy an auto shop that has heists and jobs. It's pretty cool. There's one for free, which is convenient, and so now it's time to become a mechanic. Cue the second uncomfortably long cutscene featuring a promiscuous couple and my character watching them for a weirdly long time before making his presence known. Family-friendly voyeurism fun. The garage is genuinely cool, and this is definitely my favorite business yet. We work on some of the finest vehicles in Los Santos here, and clearly value sanitation, as everything is unrealistically clean for a garage. My immersion is quite frankly shattered. It's time to do some setup missions. Crosby says he needs to go and hide a corpse in real life, so while we wait for him, I do a little family-friendly pranking. My girlfriend once pranked me so damn well. She's mixed race and half Vietnamese, and we were traveling around an Asian country a few years ago. There were all these old seedy white dudes with young Asian girls on their arms. She waited for us to be surrounded by tourists and then yanked my arm and said in a thick accent, "You promised me handbag, take me home now." All these tourists just stopped and looked at me like I was not only a seedy malacca, but also apparently pretty stingy. The promiscuous couple wants me to steal their car back, and it's at this police station. I begin firing rockets down into the car park, killing everyone, including young Crosby. We're like the Soviet Union during the Battle of Kursk. In fact, we're like the Soviet Union in general. They really didn't care how many of their own men died. We steal the car and return it to the garage. The couple then offer me a fat line, and Thick Man is just like, hell yeah, let's party. It turns out they were just messing with me, and it's just artificial sweetener. Firstly, it's pretty rude to offer someone something exciting, and then immediately replace it with a diet sugar substitute, and two, I like a Christian prank as much as the next larrikin, but the lads and I have been out there literally sacrificing our lives while these two dodgy malakas have been setting up elaborate tomfooleries. At least Crosby is ready for action, Desert Storm or otherwise. There's three heists to choose from, and we decide to attempt the bank contract. To rob these banks, we'll need thermal charges. Also, I guess Rockstar was right. Thick Man actually doesn't look both ways before crossing the road. That's on me. Now, more often than not, the lads and I will put having a laugh above completing a mission efficiently. This particular mission, however, was executed with clinical efficiency. The phrase clinical efficiency actually doesn't make much sense, as I'm basically saying efficient efficiency, but unnecessary adjectives aside, we are gaming. This was like a scene from a movie. It's no surprise that performances like this have led to distinguished and respected GTA speedrunner DarkViperAU saying these comments.
Thick Man is a speedrunning god. No one is more respected or admired.
Wow, high praise, and after implementing a whole lot of meta speedrunning strategies that will likely change the entire speedrunning subculture forever, we complete the prep. I'm glad to see this lass is not helping out at all around here. In fact, she's on her laptop catfishing miners on Club Penguin. The hustle never sleeps, I guess. It's now time for the final heist prep, where we use signal jammers to disable the bank's security systems. My character is riddled with through and through bullet wounds, but he's still out here working. Kids these days are so soft, I bet they would call in sick if they got shot several times. It's like, why even bother catfishing them? They're just gonna complain the entire time.
Nothing but a heartache. Tell me why. Nothing but a mistake. Shut up, I'm trying to vibe.
You just look like an elaborate stripper, if I'm being honest.
Military special ops, prostitution, branch.
We grab the signal jammers from the back of a beat up sedan and roll out. Now, if the last heist prep was a gold medal run, this was most definitely not. We arrive at the first bank and the front doors are locked for some reason. Honestly, pretty smart decision making by the teller, as a military chopper did just land on the road out the front. We get busy messing around and don't realize that there's a finite amount of time to complete the objective. In every person's life, there's a moment where they need to clutch up and get results. For the unknown rebel, it was when he took a literal pro-democracy stance in front of several tanks, as his extreme protest made him a worldwide acclaimed icon for life. For the boys and I, it's far more significant. We must successfully complete this heist prep on our first attempt. I jam the second security system, but with only 4 minutes left, our task is near impossible. There's no time to fetch one of my cars, so I have to commit the crime of Grand Theft Auto. Fortunately, there's a Porsche nearby, which I hop into. Do you ever notice how easily these GTA characters shuffle from the passenger seat to the driver's seat? They make it look so easy, it's actually a huge pain to do that in real life. My immersion is broken again. I want to see these characters get their knees caught up on the dashboard and maybe strain a hammy. We complete the mission with 42 seconds to spare, or roughly the same amount of time it takes a Giga Chad to make love. Or so I was told by one of my Discord mods, so you know it's real. The Modest Pelican Discord is actually popping off, you should join us. We're going to get a Battlefield 2042 server going once that game drops, it'll be a good time. Now though, it's time to heist. I make my way back to the auto shop, and this woman is still not helping at all, which at this point is blatantly disrespectful. I like to be a relaxed boss, but at what point do I start docking wages? At least she's still not grooming kids on Club Penguin, just kidding, she's got the phone app, no one's safe. This heist will have us hitting every Fleeker bank across Los Santos in one go, and we'll be doing it in true Drift King style, with souped up drift cars and paper bags on our heads. This is how I always imagined GTA heists would be for some reason. My slack-ass employee, Sasanta, gives me a buzz, but I hang up on her immediately. I'm not going to be micromanaged by a woman or man who doesn't put in an honest 8 hours a day. We arrive at the first bank and strike fear into their hearts with sick drifts. I storm through the front door and realize I forgot to put my paper bag on my head before I entered the premises. A tactical masterclass. Using the thermite charges, we melt the locks down, and just like that, we're inside the vault. It also appears that we've learned to grab stacks of cash off tables far more efficiently since the casino heist. Remember how he used to take one band at a time? Man was less efficient than Sasanta. One bank down, five to go. Crosby also made sure to murder all civilians and witnesses, which I think we can all respect. We arrive at bank number two.
Yeah, what's up, my G? Well, mate, we're friends. We're nice robbers, bro. Oh.
We went down.
You can live. What the?
Oh man, what have we done? I've started a fire inside. I can't help you.
What have you done?
I'm a human torch. All right, let's go.
We arrive at bank number 3 and I lay down covering fire for the lads. I was procrastinating while making this video and I started to look into real world bank heists. The coolest one I found was a gang of 25 Brazilian dudes who set up a fake landscaping business and spent 3 months digging a 256-foot tunnel right under a major bank. They stole $72 million and most of them never got caught, and that was only in 2005, so I mean, shoot your shot. If you plan carefully, you could probably rob at least something or someone. It happens in the real world all the time. Live, laugh, dream, extortion. Every good heist story has a betrayal, and so I proceed to do what I have to do.
Sorry, Robbie, this is how it always had to go, bro.
Jeff, please, no, mate. Jeff, I've got a pipe bomb up your ass. Oh, God.
We deliver the presumably millions and millions of dollars to the client and receive a small fraction back as our payment. $160,000, but it's not about the destination, it's about the friends you make along the way. Though I was already friends with Robbo and Crosby, so it kind of was about the destination. The auto shop runs as a business now as well, which is cool. So Santa actually calls me and lets me know a client has dropped off a car for modification. She actually did some meaningful work. I'm in a state of shock. This is the car they want me to modify for them. I spray the car a deep rich brown and balance it out with a lime underglow to give it a distinct Shrek swamp vibe. The off-road wheels, splashed with pink paint, transform this car from a means of transportation to modern art. I might have to do a separate video slowly going through how I designed this vehicle so you can get one for yourself. It's simply breathtaking. I deliver the car to the client and I kid you not, she doesn't even throw me a thank you. I do make a cool $82,000 for my work, but the only thing I like more than cash money is basic mannerisms, so I do what I have to do. I torch her house so she remembers to show gratitude going forward. I'm posting loads of content on my other YouTube channel, Papa Pelly.
You've upset me.
Alright,
well, I'm disappointed in you. I expected more. I really thought you were better.
Alright. I'll tell you what's got me acting up, alright?
Tell me. Go on.
I met this f***ing dude. Like, I was doing so well, then I met this guy. He goes by the name of, like, the Mind Goblin.
Yeah, he sounds like a f***ing loser, doesn't he?
Mind Goblin D's nuts.
Otherwise, thanks for watching, you absolute legends. I love you all. Until next time, and as always, stay classy.